Hey guys, this is Joe. Welcome him to the world of knowledge. Hey Joe, let's ask him a few questions. What's 6 into 9? Well, that was quite simple, wasn't it? Now what's root of 4? Well done, he's smart enough. Okay, now tell me what's 72 into 39, or root of 1650, or 64 raised to 5. Apparently, that was too hard on him. Well, what he lacked was some knowledge about
logarithms.
But firstly, what is logarithm and why do we use it? Let's find out. We know that 3 into 3 into 3 into 3 can be written as base 3 raised to the power 4, which equals 81. The above equation can also be written as log to the base 3 of 81 equals 4. Now let us consider one more example. 2 into 2 into 2 is equal to 2 raised to 3, that is 8, which can be written as log to the base 2 of 8 equals 3. So we can say that logarithm gives us the power to which its base must be raised to get the desired number. Hence, logarithm is nothing but another way of representing exponential equations. But where did logarithm come from? Back in 1614, a Scottish mathematician named John Napier invented logarithms in the need to simplify mathematical calculations. The objective was to simplify multiplication and division to the level of addition and subtraction. Of course, in this era of cheap calculators and other devices, logarithm is not much in use. But it still serves as a useful tool in various fields of science and technology. Let us take a simple example. Consider multiplying 10 with 100. Here, we are dealing with a decimal number system. Hence, it is convenient for us to take the base as 10. Now, taking log with the base 10 of this product, we get this. Since logarithm represents the power of base, log with the base 10 of 10 into 100 can be written as log with the base 10 of 10 plus log with the base 10 of 100. As we all know, according to the rules of indices, a raised to b into a raised to c equals a raised to b plus c. That is, when two numbers of same base but different powers are multiplied, the powers just add up. Further, log with the base 10 of 10 is 1 and log with the base 10 of 100 is 2. So 1 plus 2 gives us 3. So for the final result, we need to raise the base 10 to the power 3. That is, 10 raised to 3 is 1000. Therefore, calculations using logarithm involves analyzing the problem, taking logarithm with an appropriate base, and finally raising the base to the number we get after simplification, which means taking anti-log. Now let's take another example. 12.75 multiplied by 6.2. Taking log with the base 10, we get log with the base 10 of 12.75 plus log with the base 10 of 6.2, which equals to 1.8979. Taking anti-log, that is 10 raised to 1.8979, which equals 79.04. Why do we use base as 10? What is base of log? John Napier invented. Now, the term Napierian logarithm is often taken to address logarithms which was originally invented by Napier. The Napierian logarithm or NaPlog is related to the modern logarithms as. Now, modern logarithms are the ones which we are familiar with. The graphical representation of log with the base 10 shows that log with the base 10 of 1 is 0. Log with the base 10 of 10 is 1 and log with the base 10 of 100 is 2. This property of log with the base 10 made mathematical calculations even simpler and much more convenient in the decimal number system. This idea was suggested by an English mathematician, Henry Briggs. Also, after a couple of years, few mathematicians observed that the integral of 1 by x followed the properties of logarithm and showed similar graphical behavior. This logarithm is known as natural logarithm, and its base was found to be a constant value, that is e equals 2.71828182845 9, and so on. Few applications of logarithm are earthquake intensity measurement, to guide ships and sea navigations, pH measurement of chemical solutions. If you liked our video, please subscribe to our channel, and thanks for watching.